Big breaking news coming in from the state of Odisha. Amid endless suspense over who will be the next chief minister, we've finally got answers to that question. Mohan Majhi is the chosen one, chosen by the BJP to be the next chief minister of Odisha. Seasoned politician, strong tribal voice in the state. Mohan Majhi is the chosen one. Let's cut across live to the announcement.
पूर्ण समर्थन करी बहुमत रे विजय करी आज भारतीय जनता पार्टी को सरकार आनी थिबारु से 4.5 कोटी ओडिया को मोर कोटि कोटि प्रणाम जनाउछि धन्यवाद दउछि एवं आज जो दीर्घ 24 वर्षर शासन थिला तार परिवर्तन हेछि एवं लोक माने जो आशा एवं आकांक्षा एवं ओडिसार विकास पई जेभरी भाव भारतीय जनता पार्टी प्रति आस्था प्रकट करश्चित भाव भारतीय जनता पार्टी आगामी दिन में ताकु संपूर्ण भाव पूरण करने सहित ओडिशा को भारत वर्ष रे एक नंबर राज्य में पहुंच करने निश्चित भाव आज संकल्प नौची एवं ता निश्चित भाव आगामी दिन में ता कार्यकारी कर समस्त को बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद नमस्कार।
अब यह कार्रवाई यही समाप्त की जाती है। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद आप सब।
Okay, official announcement made there on who the next chief minister will be. The first BJP CM of Odisha is Mohan Majhi, a tribal face, seasoned politician, a four-time MLA. And this time, of course, was voted to power from Keonjhar. So he's the chosen one right now. The BJP Central Observer Team, which has in fact just ended a legislative party meet, has confirmed that Mohan Majhi will take oath tomorrow as the Odisha Chief Minister. Hrithik Mondal is joining us live from Bhubaneswar with more details on this. Hrithik, you had told us here on India Today that Mohan Majhi is one of the top contenders for the spot, and now confirmed here that he is the Chief Minister of Odisha next.
Yes, definitely. The decision has been taken after an hour-long meeting in which Rajnath Singh played a crucial role. And what we know that currently we are just picking up that Mohan Charan Majhi, four-time MLA from Odisha's Keonjhar assembly constituency, has been elected as next chief minister, and from now onwards the politics over here in Odisha will head to another direction. We spoke to several leaders and who would be the next chief minister of Odisha now that the decision has been taken that Mohan Charan Majhi, who is an very experienced and veteran politician as per the tribal politics, he has been known as a very prominent voice, a leader of tribal section of Odisha, what we know, which is why he has been he is going to represent the state as the chief minister. He was among the toughest contender among the front runners of the CM post, but what we do know that
information we're also picking up right now, Hrithik, is that there are two deputy chief ministers also who will be sworn in tomorrow, Prabhati Pravida as well as KV Singh. So two deputy CMs, Odisha will have two deputy chief ministers who will take oath tomorrow evening along with Mohan Majhi as the chief minister. Suryagni is also live with us with more details on this. Suryagni, run us through the choice and the decision taken by the BJP. Why have they picked Mohan Majhi as the chief minister? Why have they decided that there will be two deputy CMs?
Well, Akshita, there will be two deputy CMs for Odisha, Pratibha Pravida and KV Singh Deo. They are the two deputy chief ministers, and Mohan Charan Majhi, MLA from Keonjhar, will be the chief minister. He was the chief, he was an MLA with the BJP from that particular seat from 2000 to 2009. And again from 2019 onwards, he won that particular seat. He's considered to be a loyalist. He's considered to be someone who's been there with the BJP for a long, long time from, his college days. And he's considered to be a very, very, organizational person, and a very, very, someone whom the entire legislators can have a faith in. Let's not forget that there were multiple names that were doing rounds. It had the name of Manmohan Samal, who's the state president. Then Suresh Pujari's name was also there. All these people went to meet Rajnath Singh. You know, they went to bring him from the airport. They all came together. But it's Mohan Charan Majhi, Akshita, who's the next chief minister, the CM-elect of Orissa. And, you know, it's not just a very easy decision. He is going to be the next chief minister. He's going to be the first chief minister after 27 years. Since 1997, it was Naveen Patnaik who was the chief minister of this particular state. So the BJP really wanted someone who can take everyone and, you know, continue their work, continue.
No, you're right, Suryagni. You know, he has his task cut out for him because he's following up in the footsteps of someone who's a political veteran, a political legend in Odisha, the footsteps of Naveen Patnaik. So there will be a lot riding right now on Mohan Majhi. I just want to bring in once again Hrithik Mandlana on this broadcast. Hrithik, a tribal face being chosen by the Bharatiya Janata Party in Odisha. Explain to us the significance of this particular move. They know full well how much is riding on Majhi's shoulders now.
Definitely, it's real difficult task for them. But definitely, what we can see that Mohan Majhi's election as the next chief minister would give a huge, huge boost for the tribal people over here, because we know, as per Odisha politics is concerned, tribal section plays a major role. We have a huge, you know, women supporters of Bharatiya Janata Party. They are cheering for Mohan Majhi. Let's talk to them and try to understand. अभी अभी जो फैसला हुआ है मोहन माझी होंगे ओडिशा का चीफ मिनिस्टर, क्या कहना चाहेंगे?
हम सब खुश हैं, महिला मोर्चा की टीम तरफ से उनको शुभेच्छा शुभकामनाएं है। बहुत 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 खुश हैं महिला मोर्चा, बीजेपी के हर कार्यकर्ता खुश हैं।
ओडिशा के लिए कितना महत्व रखता है मोहन माझी के चयन मुख्यमंत्री के रूप में, क्योंकि वो उस ट्राइबल सेक्शन को बिलोंग करते हैं, बहुत ही वेटरन पॉलिटिशियन माने जाते हैं?
निहाती, आज हम बधाई देना चाहते हैं। जे हम बहुत खुशी है महिला मोर्चा की तरफ से मोहन माझी जी हमारे मुख्यमंत्री बनने जा रहे हैं। ये हमारे लिए एक स्वाभाविक विषय है, और ये 25 साल का नवीन पटनायक का सरकार गया है, और नया सरकार, नया विकसित उड़ीसा, ये सबकी आशा उम्मीद है महिला के नाते सुभद्रा योजना की।
रवि नारायण जी नायक, लक्ष्मण भाद और पृथ्वीराज जी, हरिचंदन जी, इन सब सारे लोगों ने समर्थन किया, और साथ ही साथ हमारे विधायक दल के सभी सम्मानित सदस्यों ने तालियां बजाकर इसका जो है स्वागत किया। इसलिए मोहन माझी जी को मैं सर्वसम्मत भारतीय जनता पार्टी विधायक दल उड़ीसा का मैंने नेता निर्वाचित घोषित किया है। और जो
Okay, so Rajnath Singh currently speaking there at the BJP office in Bhubaneswar. Remember, there was a team of central observers, including Rajnath Singh, sent across to go ahead and be a part of the legislative party meet. Five contenders who we told you about on India Today. Mohan Majhi was the name that we'd mentioned first on India Today. And it's now been confirmed that he is going to be taking oath as the chief minister of Odisha come tomorrow. So that's something we'll track very, very closely. Odisha getting the chief minister finally. The face is Mohan Majhi. Two deputy chief ministers will also be sworn in tomorrow. All right, let's cut across to the other big swearing-in expected tomorrow, that of Chandrababu Naidu as the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh. Andhra Pradesh are all set to welcome Naidu Garu, painted yellow essentially in the TDP colours, for tomorrow's swearing-in ceremony. It will happen at the auspicious time of 11:27 a.m. That's the time Chandrababu Naidu will come onto the stage and be sworn in as the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh. Preparations are underway for the mega swearing-in ceremony. Prime Minister Modi will be there, Home Minister Amit Shah, as well as a slew of celebrities. And we'll get you those names in just a bit. Let's put the focus on the biggest question right now. What will Team Naidu look like? What will the Naidu cabinet look like? We decode that for you first in our report.
After painting the town yellow, Chandrababu Naidu is all set to take oath. Andhra Pradesh, after giving a resounding mandate, is now set to turn Naidu Nadu. On Wednesday at 11:27 a.m., Naidu will be taking oath as the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh. In a joint meeting with allies Janasena and the BJP, Naidu was named as the chosen one.
Irozna, Cyberabad unde ante. అది శ్రీ చంద్రబాబు నాయుడు గారి దార్శనికత. ఎన్డీఏ కూటమి తరపు నుంచి ముఖ్యమంత్రి అభ్యర్థిగా శ్రీ నారా చంద్రబాబు నాయుడు గారి పేరుని జనసేన పార్టీ పక్షాన నుంచి మేము బలపరుస్తున్నాం.
నాయుడు హస్ రీటరేటెడ్ దట్ హిస్ ప్రయారిటీ నంబర్ 1 విల్ బి అమరావతి.
మన రాజధాని అమరావతి, అమరావతి రాజధాని, విశాఖపట్నం ఆర్థిక రాజధానిగా ఒక ప్రత్యేకమైన సిటీగా.
Meanwhile, preparations are underway for mega swearing-in ceremony that Prime Minister Modi will be attending.
We are also looking forward for that. Amit Shah ji is coming this evening and Honorable Prime Minister is coming tomorrow morning, and we have message from Eknath Shinde ji that he would be here. Yogi ji, we were expecting him, but because of some unforeseen problem, he had to stay back.
Both the leaders are talking with each other. I'm sure it's not a question of what do we really sit down to talk only about the post. It's about how we share our responsibilities in governing the state. And part of that is definitely the ministerial cabinet that is going to be formed. So hopefully by this evening, by 6:30 or 7, I think there'll be a lot more clarity.
Questions loom, however, on who will get what in the Naidu cabinet. Sources have told India Today that majority of the berths will be reserved for TDP.
Telugu Desam Party led Janasena and Bharatiya Janata Party leaders are in talks regarding the seat sharing, 25 ministerial berths here for Andhra Pradesh cabinet. Who will make the cut? The Janasena, according to sources, has asked for 3 to 4 seats, while the BJP will hold 2 seats in the Andhra Pradesh cabinet.
But the biggest buzz is over power star turned power neta Pawan Kalyan and whether he will be named as the deputy chief minister of Andhra Pradesh. Kalyan's party Janasena has scored 100% strike rate and bagged all 21 seats that they contested, and there's been endless speculation on what Pawan Kalyan's role will be in Team Naidu.
Superstar, power star, Pitapuram MLA, Janasena chief, deputy CM?
I don't know. You're talking to me. Maybe too many titles are there, which I don't. For me, it is like I'm Pawan Kalyan, and whatever life gives me, comes to me, I'll do it whatever best I could.
So you're not denying it, sir?
No, not deputy CM. No, I'm not. We're not thinking about it. As on now, I think we'll take us 2-3 more days. We'll think about the state issues and how the power sharing and all. We'll talk about it.
The stage is now set for a historic swearing-in ceremony in Vijayawada's Ganavaram, as Chandrababu Naidu and team will take oath to transform Andhra Pradesh. With Apurva Jayachandran in Vijayawada, Bureau Report, India Today.
And Naidu and co pulling all stops to ensure that this truly is a historic swearing-in ceremony. We've scooped the invite list here on India Today, and it's going to be a star-studded show in Ganavaram, in Vijayawada tomorrow, because Chiranjeevi and Ram Charan, both of course related to Pawan Kalyan, have confirmed that they are attending the oath-taking ceremony. Of course, for them, this is going to be a hugely emotional moment, because Pawan Kalyan's brother Chiranjeevi is going to be witnessing Pawan Kalyan in all likelihood take oath as the deputy chief minister. Ram Charan is Chiranjeevi's son, thereby Pawan Kalyan's nephew, so he too is attending. But besides that, we're also hearing that superstar Rajnikanth, another veteran actor Mohan Babu, they've also been invited. Allu Arjun, Pawan Kalyan's nephew, has also been invited. junior NTR as well. Now, big question mark on whether all of them will attend too, particularly junior NTR. It will be very interesting to see whether he turns up for Chandrababu Naidu's swearing-in ceremony or not, considering the turbulence within the family. Apoorva Jayachandran is joining us live with more details on this. Apoorva, expecting, of course, all of the stars to touch down in Vijayawada tomorrow for the mega swearing-in ceremony. We've got the invite list. Any details of who've confirmed that they'll be attending?
Well, Akshita, what we do know is there are, several VIPs who are expected to arrive here in Vijayawada tomorrow as the oath-taking ceremony is all set to take place at Gannavaram. In fact, we're also being told that senior leaders from the NDA, including Prime Minister Modi, as well as Union Home Minister Amit Shah, JP Nadda and several others, have also been invited by the NDA alliance out here in Andhra Pradesh. They will also be arriving here and will be partaking in the swearing-in ceremony that is scheduled to take place at 11:27 a.m. That's the auspicious timing that has been given, wherein Chandrababu Naidu, along with a team of ministers, will be sworn in tomorrow by this time. Remember, this is going to be an important swearing-in ceremony. This will be the fourth time that Chandrababu Naidu takes oath as the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, and this time it will be yet again in an NDA alliance with the Jana Sena's Pawan Kalyan and Andhra Pradesh Bharatiya Janata Party's Purandeshwari. It's going to be these three leaders who are going to be finalizing the seats there. Remember, 25 ministerial berths, and it's going to be a talk between the JSP, the TDP and the BJP as to see who is going to get what seats. The Jana Sena from their side has requested for three to four seats, and most likely,
we get to the cabaret berths in just a bit. Apoorva, just stay with me because we've got more details of who's invited for the grand swearing-in ceremony tomorrow. This is a list of netas who've been invited, and at the top of that list is Prime Minister Narendra Modi, who's also confirmed his attendance. He's going to be there to witness Chandrababu Naidu taking oath as the Andhra Chief Minister. We've all, of course, been seeing the bonhomie between Chandrababu Naidu and Prime Minister Modi, even during the NDA meet, during the meeting that took place in the Central Hall of Parliament. Those images on your screens. Prime Minister Modi will be there. Amit Shah is touching down in Vijayawada today. We'll be holding a meeting with Chandrababu Naidu later tonight, so he's going to be there. Nitish Kumar, again, who you see in those images, part of the NDA, a big stakeholder, is also going to be there for the swearing-in. Besides that, other BJP CMs, the Rajasthan CM, Uttarakhand CM, Eknath Shinde will be there. Yogi Adityanath has been invited, but I'm hearing that he may not make it because of prior commitments. Interestingly, the only non-BJP chief minister who's invited, and rightly so perhaps, is Telangana Chief Minister Revant Reddy. And there have been quite some welcoming pleasantries really exchanged between Chandrababu Naidu and Revant Reddy on social media as well, signalling, of course, hopefully positive things to come as far as Telangana-Andhra relations are concerned. But Apoorva, back across to you on this. BJP chief ministers invited, all of them expected to be there except for Yogi Adityanath, if I'm not wrong. Prime Minister Modi will be there, Home Minister Amit Shah. So you've got, all of the biggest leaders from across the country, at least as far as the NDA goes, present in Vijayawada tomorrow.
Well, that's right. It's going to be a massive show of support for the NDA here tomorrow as, Nara Chandrababu Naidu is being sworn in for the fourth time as the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh. Remember, this is an NDA alliance that has been stitched together, Akshita, quite well, in fact, I must add, because earlier on it was the Jana Sena and the Telugu Desam Party that had formed alliances. There were talks and questions going around if the NDA is also going to be welcoming the Telugu Desam Party into the alliance. And finally, we got to know that the Jana Sena, Telugu Desam and the Bharatiya Janata Party will be going ahead and fighting these elections. And rightly so, because the numbers that we're getting from the Andhra Pradesh Assembly results do prove what kind of a strong alliance they have set in place. And tomorrow, it's also going to be a show of, their strength.
A show of solidarity, a show of strength, which we witnessed in Delhi. Now we're going to be witnessing that in Andhra Pradesh. Apoorva, thanks very much for joining us with all of those details. I'll reconnect connect also with my colleague Abdul Bashir in just a bit. I want to bring in on this broadcast for the moment T.S. Sudhir, political analyst who tracks very, very closely political developments in Andhra and Telangana. Sudhir, namaskaram. We're counting down, of course, to the swearing-in ceremony. A lot of questions about what the cabinet, the 25-member cabinet, is going to look like, Sudhir. Naidu is going to have to accommodate requests from the Janasena, from the BJP. He's going to have to look at caste equations, ensuring appropriate regions also are represented. What do you think will be weighing in on his mind when he decides the final names?
Well, 26 is the maximum number he can possibly have. So, but much more important than the number of ministers from the Janasena and the BJP, which I'm told will not exceed 6, 4 plus 2, it will be much more difficult for Chandrababu Naidu to cater to the requests and the demands by so many legislators within the Telugu Desam, given the fact that in most of the districts of Andhra Pradesh, the YSRCP did not manage to win even a single seat. So there will be a lot of demands because there are senior TDP leaders like Gorantla Buchayar Chaudhary, Acham Naidu. There are also first-timers like Aditi Gajpati Raju, the daughter of Ashok Gajpati Raju, and Bojjala Sudhir Reddy. So in that sense, there's a mix of the old and the new. And it will be interesting to watch what kind of an image Naidu wants to give as part of Naidu 4.0. Because he would be very keen that this particular innings, he also marks a departure from the rest. He's already told his TDP colleagues that this time he's going to be much more accessible to his party colleagues so that they don't accuse him of neglecting his party work while he's the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh. But on the point of Deputy Chief Ministership, which you were talking about for Pawan Kalyan, now, Pawan Kalyan, of course, would want, at least his Janasena would definitely want him to be the Deputy CM, the sole Deputy CM preferably, because in the past, Naidu has had two Deputy CMs between 2014 and 19, but a Deputy CM who wields real power, because they would also be very mindful of the fact that during the YSRCP rule, they would always accuse and take a jibe at Pawan Kalyan, calling him a package star who takes instructions from Naidu. So he would want to be seen as a leader, as a deputy CM in his own right. That is something very important for the Janasena leadership and cadre. The YSRCP, of course, had 5 deputy chief ministers, but they were largely ornamental posts with no real pass. So as far as Pawan Kalyan is concerned, he would want a post where he can actually do something for the good of the people. So the portfolio also will be extremely significant. You spoke about the film stars. Yes, it's a story of two film families, the Chiranjeevi family and the NTR family. And two names, two faces will be looked out for. One, of course, Allu Arjun, who actually campaigned for his friend who belonged to the YSRCP from Nandyal, Shilpa Ravi Reddy, who lost this particular election. And junior NTR, who has always been spoken about as some kind of the inheritor, a possible inheritor to the NTR legacy. I think that question has been firmly shut up for now with the kind of mandate that Telugu Desam has got now. And Nara Lokesh will be really seen as a second in command after Chandrababu Naidu within the Telugu Desam.
I think the face that I'll definitely be looking out for is junior NTR, because the messaging, if he actually turns up for the swearing-in ceremony, is going to be so interesting. The other aspect, Sudhir, when you look at the cabinet, is about how Chandrababu Naidu will ensure accommodation of faces from Rayalaseema and coastal Andhra. The TDP made a comeback in these two regions. So Naidu will want to send across a message that, look, you voted for us, we're ensuring adequate representation of these parts.
Absolutely. In fact, the last time he had the two deputy chief ministers, one of them, Chinna Rajappa, was from North Coastal Andhra. The other, K.E. Krishnamurthy, was from the Rayalaseema region, from Kurnool district. So he would want to balance the regional aspect from Rayalaseema as well as North Coastal Andhra, because these two are relatively the more backward regions compared to Coastal Andhra, the Central Andhra region. The second part, which Naidu is usually very good at, is to give an equal representation to different castes. The OBCs, and even to an extent, the Reddy community voted in a large number for the Telugu Desam. Now, that's a huge thing because they are generally known to back the YSR Congress. So, he would want to give a significant representation to both the OBC community as well as the Reddys to acknowledge the kind of mandate the people of Andhra Pradesh have given to Chandrababu Naidu. Today, at the meeting where Naidu was elected the leader formally, you could see both Pawan Kalyan and Naidu get very emotional. Now, that's a very different Naidu from what we have seen him in the past. So you could see at 74, Chandrababu Naidu is going to be, my sense is, going to be a very different kind of a chief minister in his what could perhaps turn out to be last innings if he actually decides to pass on the baton to Nara Lokesh sometime midway into the tenure.
Do you see Nara Lokesh being a part of the cabinet then, Sudhir? Some, you know, suggesting and speculating that he could perhaps take a bigger role in the party itself, more of a leadership role in the party, work on that front and not be a part of the cabinet, or could get a very important portfolio, one of the two.
Well, when he was an MLC, Nara Lokesh was the IT and the, I mean, he was also handling the industries for Andhra Pradesh. I think he was sworn in sometime midway in the first innings of between 2014 and 19. So I would expect that Nara Lokesh would be there. Naidu would want to see him as the kind of leader, the minister who negotiates, who deals with the industry, the young face, do something what K.T. Rama Rao was doing for Telangana when the BRS was in power. So in that sense, just like we have seen in so many states, whether it's in Tamil Nadu, Stalin and Udayanidhi, in Maharashtra earlier, Uddhav Thackeray and Aditya Thackeray, earlier Mulayam Singh Yadav and Akhilesh Yadav. So I sense the training would be there in order for Nara Lokesh to get more ministerial experience to deal with different subjects possibly get ready to don the mantle of the chief minister when the time comes. So I do definitely see him as the chief minister, but more importantly, he will also play an important role within the Telugu Desam. He's already the general secretary. In fact, we do see him taking a more aggressive role vis-a-vis the YSRCP, which will be in the role of a rather diminished opposition. So I'm not really expecting Chandrababu Naidu to be that real aggressive face vis-a-vis the YSRCP, but much more of a Nara Lokesh leading the charge against the opposition.
My final question to you, Sudhir, is about the meeting that happened this morning where you had Chandrababu Naidu reiterating that Amravati is very much the capital of Andhra Pradesh. But he also made a very, very specific mention about Visakhapatnam being a commercial capital and the fact that the TDP will focus on developing Vizag. What's the messaging behind that? Do you think he was trying to also placate all of the MLAs who are right now vying for ministerial berths from Vizag?
Well, Visakhapatnam, even during the time that Naidu was talking about Amaravati in his first innings as chief minister of the divided state of Andhra Pradesh, used to talk about it as the IT capital, also as the financial capital. So that status for Visakhapatnam has really not gone away. Also to be remembered is the fact that the TDP obviously has done pretty well in the north coastal Andhra Pradesh, and they do realize that Vizag will continue to be the magnet given the fact that it is the biggest city as far as Andhra Pradesh is concerned. So he does not want Visakhapatnam or Kurnool to feel as though once again all the eggs will be placed in the Amravati basket. He wants to promise that it will be decentralized development, but development according to different kind of areas. Since it is having the access to the port, it will be developed as the financial capital. There will be the manufacturing hub which will be coming up in the Rayalaseema region. Kurnool mm-hmm. could be developed for other kinds of interest. So basically trying to ensure decentralized development and not make the mistake which earlier people made with Hyderabad, that only Hyderabad was developed as a magnet and the rest of the cities in Andhra Pradesh, in United Andhra Pradesh, were not.
Okay, interesting perspective, Sudhir. We look forward to having you with us from 10 a.m. tomorrow morning as we'll be counting down and looking at all of the live updates coming in from Gannavaram for the swearing-in ceremony. Thanks for the moment. Thank you very much for joining us here on India Today. Let's cut across to more breaking updates coming in right now on the oath-taking ceremony. Okay, so the stage clearly set for Naidu's swearing-in ceremony. We're going to get you images now of the kind of preparations that are underway. It's going to be a mega event. On the extreme right of your screens are images of the preparations that are underway. And from the scale of what you're seeing in that ground of the setup, you can tell how big an event this is going to be. Abdul Bashir is joining us with more details on this. Abdul, take it away. Gannavaram all decked up, ready for the big, big Naidu show tomorrow.
Well, absolutely. The IT park in Gannavaram is all set for a big, NDA show, especially the TDP showdown tomorrow, where TDP chief Nara Chandrababu Naidu is set to take oath as the chief minister of Andhra Pradesh. Many ministers are also going to swear in the cabinet of Nara Chandrababu Naidu, including the Janasena party and also from the Bharatiya Janata party. So this is said to be a big day for the state of Andhra Pradesh, especially for TDP, JSP and NDA, BJP alliance that is there in the state of Andhra Pradesh. So here all the preparations are in full swing. All the security measures have been taken. The VVIPs who are to be arrived, including Prime Minister Narendra Modi, to Union Home Minister Amit Shah, Kishan Reddy, Bandi Sanjay, to celebrities and chief ministers from other states have also been invited, including Revanth Reddy, to Eknath Shinde, Rajasthan CM, and all the chief ministers from the NDA, NDA ruled state chief ministers have been invited, and celebrities like Chiranjeevi, Junior NTR, Ram Charan, and other celebrities like Rajnikant has also been given an invitation to be present in the audience here tomorrow in the oath-taking ceremony where Nara Chandrababu Naidu will take oath as the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh at exactly 11:27 a.m., which is said to be a Shubh Murat or auspicious time for Nara Chandrababu Naidu to take oath as Chief Minister of the state of Andhra Pradesh.
All right, thanks very much, Abdul. Abdul and Apurva will be getting us all the updates from the ground on what's playing out of the swearing-in ceremony, which will happen at 11:27 a.m. But our coverage will kick off from early in the morning as we get you all the live updates from Gannavaram. Chandrababu Naidu, all set to take oath as the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh. Remember that he's served as the Chief Minister once before of bifurcated Andhra, but of united Andhra Pradesh, he's been the CM twice. In the late 90s, his style of governance with a clear focus of developing Hyderabad as the cyber city of modern India earned him the nickname of CEO of Andhra Pradesh. Now, it's because of this tag of development king that perhaps he's come back with this huge mandate. So there's a lot of pressure on Naidu to kind of replicate what he did with Hyderabad with Amravati this time.
Chandrababu Naidu, in his first two terms as the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, earned the nickname of being the CEO of the state. Postgraduate in economics, Chandrababu's functioning as the chief minister in the late 90s was very corporate in style that relied more on performance and tangible economic growth rather than traditional vote bank politics. It was reflected in the growth of the capital city of Andhra Pradesh, Hyderabad. It transitioned from being the Nizam city to a cyber hub of modern India with the growth of Hyderabad Information Technology and Engineering Consultancy or High-Tech City, also known as Cyberabad. Situated towards the northwestern region of Hyderabad, High-Tech City is a major high-tech business district. All thanks to Chandrababu Naidu, who impressed Bill Gates and ensured Microsoft to locate its India Development Center in Andhra Pradesh. His efforts were recognized globally, earning him several accolades, including being named South Asian of the Year by the Time magazine in 1999. Today, High Tech City is one of the leading IT, health informatics, bioinformatics and engineering hubs of India, the foundation of which was laid in the first two terms of Chandrababu Naidu as the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh. In the decade that Chandrababu Naidu spent in the opposition bench, Andhra Pradesh was bifurcated and Telangana was born with Hyderabad as the common capital. Post-bifurcation, when Andhra Pradesh needed to plan its new capital city, the TDP Supremo in his third term proposed development of Amravati. He faced strong opposition and when he lost power to Jagan Mohan Reddy, led YSRCP in 2019, everything stalled. In his third term as the Chief Minister of bifurcated Andhra Pradesh, he also launched several programs like Smart Village, Smart Watt to transform rural Andhra Pradesh, all in continuation to his CEO-style functioning as the Chief Minister of the state. Andhra Pradesh has once again voted Chandrababu Naidu to power, hoping that he finishes the work started a decade back and lessens the gap between the rural-urban divide in the development of the state. Bureau Report, India Today.
And starting 10 a.m. tomorrow morning, we'll be live on all the images coming in from Gannavaram of that mega swearing-in ceremony that will take place in Andhra Pradesh.